Coming to MRA basics. Yesterday we have learnt about transverse magnetization vector. Okay. This is a transverse magnetic vector. This transverse magnetic vector, it moves in phase with the precessing protons. It moves in phase with the precessing protons. So this moving, this is a magnetic field, right? This transverse magnetization, it's constantly moving, constantly changing its direction, and it induces an electric current. So this moving magnetic field, it induces an electric current. From this we get the MR signal. So this precessing protons, they have a precession frequency. So as this transverse magnetic vector also moves in phase with this precessing protons, it also has a precession frequency, and in turn the electrical current which from where we get the magnetic MR signal also has a precession frequency. So next point is, from which part of the body we are getting this signal. So for this, if you take a cross section of the body, at each point in time we are applying different strength of magnetic field. For example, we have a Larmor equation, that is precession frequency is equal to gyromagnetic ratio into magnetic field. So at each point in time, that is when the precession frequency, when the magnetic field strength increases, the precession frequency also increases. That at each point in time we are applying different magnetic field. So the protons in each section which are precessing have different precession frequency. This is different magnetic field strength at each point of the cross section. The precession frequency also will be different for each section. In turn, the MR signal which we are getting, it also has a different precession frequency. So by looking into this precession frequency at each point in time, we can know from which part of the body we are getting the MR signal. Thank you.